that okay?
Yeah, that means live.
That was terrible direction, Emma.
It's my hand signal.
We are live on the fake telly. It's episode 6 of Jessie's homemade garden jam. I've got a delightful and delicious bunch of boys in the background. They're the most handsome rabble of men you've ever seen. Not to objectify, but I just have objectified. I'm wearing 6 to 7 layers. Yeah, lots. And I have a hot water bottle, so hopefully Fiona Kelly frozen fingers won't happen. And I got my mittens. I'm going to share that we've gone live and do that thing where I can see my own self. How's everybody doing? How many people got online? Emma's pointing at the boys to play some music in the background. So maybe they'll start soon. There I am live. Okay, here we go. 4 people are online. Hello.
I'm going to share this.
Live now.
There I am live. Okay, here we go. 4 people are online.
Okay, so meta. Rosalind says bring him on camera, the sexy boys.
Tell her she'll have to wait.
She'll have to wait, Rosalind. Shall we fill everybody in? So we got 4 people on. There's probably more on the way. Shall we have a look at our babies? Who's that? Come on, brass boys, give some music. Oh, he's a wee treat. He's
still, that's still allowed.
Well, while we're doing that, let's have a look over here at the progress. Slightly concerning. Wizard beans are only 3 of them. But look at these lads. We're getting to some true leaves. I think live on air next week, I'm going to pop some out. Turnips again, like who wants turnips? But there we go, that's a bit of sound. Sweet. I told them to have fun, so they're completely taking a mickey now. Chard, lettuce, beetroot, kale. Ah, there we go. Now we've got an intro. Now we've got some music. I mean, Jessie's homemade garden jam after all. Definitely homemade. Just what all 6 of you are gathered. Remind you that it'd be nice if you could buy a ticket. 3 quid, 3,000 quid, whatever you can afford. Emma's titled this one Brassic, Brass and Brassica. Apparently Brassic means broke, which we all are. So if you can, paypal.me/JessieGrimes. And all of our profits will go to help musicians at the end of all of this. I'll tot up everything, pay my musicians, and everything else is going to go to help musicians. So it's a worthy cause. We have some brass wives and or girlfriends, wags, in the audience. Reliable neighbours are coming. Do you have any more stories? So this is our penultimate one. We've been absolutely blessed with the weather. Do you want to pan up to the sky, Emma? So nice. Concerned. We've got the neighbours. Yes! We're going to bring an electric piano out for the Jackan trio because they did our first one. It's only right that they do the last, and maybe with some special guests. But I'm a bit concerned it's going to rain. So we might have a first of being inside next week. But I'm hoping, just to stave off the old gloom and depression, of doing one a month indoors over the winter. So you'll still see my silly face, and we'll fill the living room with plants, and maybe even start outside and show what's died and what's still living in the garden. So we'll still continue with some jams. These boys are just drinking tea now and whispering. Do you want to pan over and show them off? Look at them.
We said play along while I'm chatting in time.
It's classic. We could just kick things off. Should we get going? Go meet the boys? Are they getting ready to play again now? They're just whispering. I want to see how long they're going to stay whispering. No, they're just looking at me now. Let's go meet them. Hello, boys.
Hello.
Oh, hi.
Hello.
Hi
there. That's strong background music.
Thank you so much.
All 2 minutes of it.
Yeah.
Great.
Off the cuff.
Shall we meet them?
So, let's meet the boys.
Hi.
Sebastian
Philpott. Hello, nice to meet you.
Barnaby
Philpott. Hiya. How are you doing?
Richard.
Hello there.
James Pillai.
Hi there.
Rowdy people in the back. And Geoghegan.
Hello.
Yeah.
Hi.
Hi.
Den's there. Den's
hey,
always
Den.
There.
Hi.
Hey, Den.
Den.
Hey,
or Shine, he's there. We got some treats for you The boys are going to put them. We're going to have a Philpott Brothers potato off. They're ready. They've been growing for months and months.
So the potatoes.
Hey! It's Barney's first one. Should we do a tally of how many gags Barney could do? That's number one.
It's always the same format.
It's a close structure.
I need to. I was killing time there before introducing you guys, but I'm going to play. Two.
Sorry. Sebkin.
Hi. Nice to meet you.
Tell us a bit about the next piece we're going to hear while we discuss clarinet together.
The next piece of music is called Three Preludes, but we're just going to do the first one first. And it's by George Gershwin. Yes, that's right. The American composer that was very influenced by jazz music and wrote some of the best pieces of music ever written, such as Rhapsody in Blue. He wrote An American in Paris, that music. What else did he do? He wrote musicals. He wrote like American in Paris, but he wrote Porgy and Bess. That's a proper opera as well, isn't it? It's definitely not Summertime. But he was fantastic. He he wrote with his brother Ira. It's not his wife. It was a man called Ira.
I thought it was his wife.
Yeah.
The lyricist, right?
No lyrics for this song. Originally, it's a piano piece. But it has been done. You've got the music there for clarinet and piano.
Yeah, James Cohen did it. Other people have done it as well. Me and Karis Hanning of the Jack Andrew, who'll be playing the penultimate jam next week, do it. So unfortunately,
the final jam.
I get my words mixed up. The final jam. This is the penultimate one. You're right. Karis has been usurped for this week, but she wasn't too upset when she heard it because she thought it was actually quite good. Seb Philpott in about 7.2 seconds arranged these fantastically, so he should get a little virtual clap.
Oh, thank you.
Governor.
If anyone needs any arrangements done, Seb needs the work, guys. Give him a gig.
Yeah, and he's really quick and really good.
Yeah, really quick, really good.
Very expensive.
Yeah. Okay, shall we?
Yeah. Super excited immediately with garden themed music. Yes.
And got very creative, and we've got the very first ever premiere performance for this combination written by Seb Philpott. And it's going to be the theme tune to, have a guess, what's it going to be, guys?
Maybe people should guess as a place.
People, huh?
Don't tell them, let them guess.
Emma wants to,
I love guessing.
Yeah.
Keep them guessing.
Can I also make an important announcement for you boys?
Yeah.
Your mum's watching.
Hi, mum.
Hello, mum.
Okay. Hello, mother.
And your wife and baby are watching also.
Oh, that's nice.
Congratulations to Seb and Charlotte.
Hello.
Hi, Charlotte.
Okay, sorry.
So, this is the theme tune to something. What is it?
Are you going to do any percussion in this one? No.
It's the next one, isn't it?
Oh, for you! Oh my god!
That could have been a great. Oh, I've done a spoiler there. I'm sure it wasn't.
Oh.
No spoilers.
Oh, it's alright. Okay, that makes sense now, right? Here we go.
Yeah, it's okay. The other one.
I'll give you one bar in. Oh, one, two, three, four.
Emma's just like zoned
out. Dan West is mostly just ripping into you guys, so I'm not reading those comments.
Still in his dressing gown.
Right, we've got a quiz. Firstly, one.
Let the people know online. Everyone gets a shout out suggestion, yeah. So people online, you can join in the quiz.
Can you name the three hosts of Groundforce?
Good one.
Huh? Super fan.
What's the third one? Charlie Dimmock.
Yes.
Charlie Dimmock, correct.
Number one.
Correct.
And Tommy.
Tommy.
It's not Robin.
No.
Tommy Greenfingers.
Tommy Greenfingers.
Anyone online got
online.
It?
Online.
They're furiously Googling.
Yeah. Seb knows it.
I got it.
Seb knows it.
Should I say it?
Go for it.
Tommy Walsh.
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay.
Not Handy Andy.
Not Handy Andy.
No. What year was it? Was it a broadcast first? It's my.
He'll know.
The year before I went to a secondary school.
I believe it was 1999.
Give it away, you better have more guessing. Okay, here's a better one, right? Super famous world leader. Yeah. They did his garden.
Was it
in the 90s? He won a Nobel Peace Prize.
Oh, wasn't Robert Mugabe?
Close. Does anyone know?
Was it Idi Amin's orangery?
These guys are doing spoilers and trolling it out.
Any guesses?
Free.
Do you know what world leader they did his garden? The 90s?
Free.
Nelson Mandela.
Nelson Mandela.
Mandela's garden. Such a great fact. And the last fact, who played the original theme tune? David, might you know? Who performed the original theme tune?
No idea, sorry.
Never heard of it.
Very famous. The oldest and best known brass band. Right? In the world.
Correct.
Named?
The Black Dyke Mills Band.
And?
Do you have a fact for us?
Might you have played...
I actually got asked to record the music for this series.
Child labour.
But I wasn't allowed because my mother wouldn't let me join the band until I'd done my GCSEs.
Bobby!
Thank you, Margaret.
So you were nearly on
so
the Groundforce soundtrack.
So close, yeah. But I was about a month away from
a month
being
off
on it.
Being on the soundtrack.
Yeah.
I mean, that would have been the greatest life.
Thanks,
you could have retired then.
I know, right.
Margaret,
I know.
Head in shame.
I've been regretting it ever since.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, so Rosalind did guess Mandela. They're just a little bit behind online. So.
Nice one. Well done.
Congratulations.
Shall we get on some more music? Some more amazing Seb Philpott arrangements.
Yeah.
What are we doing
now? A 1989 cartoon.
Oh,
13
yeah.
Episodes, 5 minutes long. Anyone remember? The garden-themed cartoon. I put a lot of it on social media. Here's a clue. I've made a shaker to play along made out of split peas. Brooke's got it. Flow online, people.
Give a shaker to a wag.
Oh, yeah. Lauren, you don't know this, but I'm going to give you a shaker.
Oh.
Cameo. Lauren Weaver's very talented oboe player. If anyone needs an oboe, you know who to call. Yay. There's a split pea shaker. It is Poddington Peas.
Yeah.
Yeah. So Seb has very strict instructions. We're playing quavers in the first A section, and then we're doing some New Orleans in the B section.
No
so
pressure, Lauren.
No pressure, Lauren. Just get it right perfectly without any practice.
There's also a split pea solo in the middle. Yeah. 84 bars. If you could take like 16 bars at H, that'd be great.
Try not to split it.
Yeah.
Yay!
Lauren Weaver.
Very good.
Just
sit down here.
Lisa Clarkson, Poddington Peas. Top marks, Lisa.
Hey,
Clarkson.
Well done, Lisa. My new sister-in-law. She's she will be when she marries my brother, which they just got engaged on Friday.
Congratulations!
Oh. Hey, maybe Saturday. I'm not
we'll
sure.
Celebrate, shall we play Poddington Peas?
Yeah, right.
This is for them.
Ready, quavers, Lauren.
What a tribute!
Okay, here we go. One bar in.
Congratulations on your engagement.
Like peas in a pod.
Hey!
Oh, that's two
Barney.
Okay,
Sebastian Philpott. Right, James Pillai.
Yes.
New challenge.
Go on.
First of all, does anyone in the real live audience or on the internet fake telly audience, can you name any of the Poddington Peas? Anybody know any of the Poddington Peas?
Nope.
A lot of little people.
Not a single one. The audience online.
Peter.
Very good.
No doubt.
They're all really silly puns with P in it. So we've made a little game. So we're going to see how fast there are 35 of them, I think. How quickly James can read the names
without messing up.
If he messes it up, it gets passed
pass
on.
But
I'm
going
to
get my time.
Oh, Hannah came up with sleepy, which I think is one of the peas. Congratulations,
Hannah. Is that our Hannah from down the road?
Yeah, it's our neighbour Hannah.
Hannah.
Sleepy.
Get into the garden. Right, no cheating, no pre-reading.
Yeah.
Oh, what?
You just got to go. Right, count down.
From the back or the front?
Dumpy, very good, Charlotte.
Okay, yeah.
Are you going to buy something?
Poddington Peas.
You two yeah. For May. Yeah, just you two on your own. Just bam.
Are you ready?
A to C.
Black on pea, bumpy, Compton hot pea, chippy, choppy, creepy, dopey, dumpy, garden pea, GP, gloppy, grumpy, happy, hippy, jumpy, that's peasy pod, Penelope, poppy, puppy, scoopy, scrappy, skippy, sleepy, sloppy, snappy, slippy, sloop, sloop.
Oh no, pass it out, pass it out, so close! Hope, where'd you finish?
Snoopy.
Alright, from the beginning.
Keep going. Okay, Snoopy, Soapy, Sweet Pea, Sweet Pea, TP, Wee Mick Pea, Wheat Pea, Zip Pea.
You just did the end.
That's it.
Right.
Oh, what? Okay.
Right.
I thought I had to carry on from where you started.
Sebastian, no, we're going to see if Seb can do
so
it all in one go.
Okay.
Are you ready?
Yep.
I don't know what I'm doing, it's a timer.
Are you going to set
ready?
Me off?
Steady, go.
Black a bee, bumpy, bumpy, hoppy, chippy, choppy, creepy, dopey, numpy, gumpy, jeepy, bumpy, grumpy, happy, hippy, jumpy, numpy, fixy, vintage, topy, poppy, scoopy, crumpy, tea, skippy, sleepy, soppy, sappy, snippy, snoop, topy, sweepy, sweepy, teepy, zeepy, weepy, mcpy, weepy, zippy.
Yes! Yay! Yes, Seb!
Thank you.
I will say, Emma tried to do it really quickly earlier. She did 24 seconds. Sebby got it in 20.
Whoa,
without a giggle, wow. And rhythmically.
Didn't
what a talented man. What a talented man.
He arranged it that way.
So nice. Should we go straight on to some Gershwin?
Yeah.
Yes, please.
We can repeat this at the end. So every time I play something, I have to put my clarinet away again because it's so cold.
Someone else will tell me. Anyone's got any Gershwin facts?
You had some, didn't you, about from your Encarta CD?
Yeah.
Encarta 3.
From my Encyclopedia Britannica when I was a kid. I had to learn this for my Viva Voce, for my diploma of the trumpet. It's like what you do after grade 8. I'm not showing off here, having an Encyclopedia Britannica and doing a grade 8. But
okay, Seb's got a grade 8.
I just remember reading about Nadia Boulanger, who was an amazing baker.
Oh, that's
sorry. I'll shut up now.
She was a lady in Paris that was an incredible musician who lots of composers went to learn with. So Gershwin learned with her, and Copland, I think Stravinsky as well.
And the one and only composer of my favourite Christmas music of all time.
Shaking Stevens.
Quincy Jones.
What's your favourite? What's the song?
The Soulful Messiah.
Oh, the Soulful Messiah. Soulful Celebration. That's great. Check that out when it's December.
We'll do it in the Christmas special.
Yeah.
I'll put it on the background. The Christmas special. Right, so we're going to play Prelude number 2, arranged by Sebastian Philpott.
Featuring
Jessie
Grimes.
Featuring May.
And like, to be fair, so we decided on this piece on Tuesday, and so Jessie's just had to suddenly like pick it up and learn it.
And played it since 2017, probably.
Yeah, exactly. It's pretty incredible.
So
we're just so talented,
all of us guys. But we're pretty broke. PayPal.me / Jessie Grimes.
Yeah. Click on the link below. Is there a link below?
Yeah, I've done it. Yeah.
Great.
The link below. Beautiful. Thanks. Seamless.
One. 2, 3, 4.
Thank you.
getting some online
Debbie.
Love.
Oh, thanks, guys.
Sasha said smooth.
Sasha's on!
Deirdre
didn't
did
know Sasha could make it. Well
cool
done.
Sunglasses.
Good speedy.
I know she's still at work. The head teacher asked her if she was watching Groundforce at work.
Yes! That deserves a promotion.
And also there's I can't remember who, but someone really
we got some fans.
Oh, wow, look, Far Away fans!
Yay!
Give us a wave! someone said that Philpott is a really good name for
it
a garden.
Is.
Oh,
yes.
Oh,
yes.
Thank you.
That's a point.
I missed.
Yeah, you did miss that.
Funny.
I only got myself to blame.
Emma's going to show us a bit of what's growing now in our garden. Do you want me to do that or are you going to do that?
No, I'll do it.
Emma wants a moment in the sun, guys. So she wants us some background music and we then sort of.
Nobody. So Jessie's always complaining about our green tomatoes, but look at the redness on these.
I know.
We've actually been getting a great crop. I've just been picking them before she gets to see them. So lots of reddening. The winter, what is it again, Jessie? Beetroots.
Beetroots.
Winter beetroots have taken. And many a marigold.
The kale in there with the marigold.
Oh yeah, the kale. The marigolds are protecting the kale. Good tip for anyone. Slugs go wild for marigolds, so plant them around your delicate lettuces and
around your
delicates to protect them. Is kale a brassica or is that only broccoli? I did say this was brassica, so I do have to just show a brassica. This is a brassica, is it not?
This is a cup of tea.
Tea and the brassicas. But what I wanted to show was, actually no, second most exciting thing is that the courgettes are definitely having a second. I've been out here interfering with them, but it's working. And then I think the philpots might be in the way, but
oh,
I want to show
the,
my second. So we all remember last week my my intimate moment with a squash, and here's the one that didn't work. This is what happens when they don't fertilize, they wither and die. But look, got one here. Where's the other one, Jessie?
The bigger one, just further along towards Dickie.
Towards Dickie.
Oh, that's another.
No, I did
there.
That one. That's a little one. That one's not fertilized yet. This one,
Emma.
I've done that one. There's another.
Oh, there she is.
No, yeah, there she is. I know it's definitely a lady because we covered that last week, didn't we?
Oh, you did.
Yeah, about. And this is your
so
bit,
this
sad.
This is Emma's musical moment that
musical
I refuse
I've been wanting
to be part
to
of. We haven't showed these off yet in our garden.
Because I've been waiting for this moment.
It's a nice story though, right? On our honeymoon, we stayed in this beautiful vegan place and I made friends with a man. We should send it to the man. And then he gave me tubers.
Say what they are.
Some tubers, mysterious tubers, to take back to London. And we planted them and they grew
right, Seb, Nazi bit. Nazi bit.
There's a moment, Seb. He's online.
See if you can guess the musical clue.
What is this plant?
I'm not sure far enough away.
Clue.
I forgot it.
Last night at the proms.
Any guesses?
I need to go right up.
Jerusalem artichokes!
That's
the talent. Oh yeah, Charlotte got it too.
So, one of the winter garden jams, we're mostly inside. Maybe one of the features is I'll go out and dig up a Jerusalem artichoke. And as an Irish person, not sing Jerusalem.
And said she almost fell over herself and dropped two babies trying to get to the phone so she could guess.
Jerusalem artichoke! Amazing. So we're now going to read a story that Quinn Cutmore Clark very generously lent to us. I'm not sure she knows about this, but she knows.
No, she's going to get pretty angry.
She's going to go mental for stealing her book. Quinn lent us her book. That's your book, isn't it, Quinn?
I'd be a bit annoyed now. So
we're going to give us
just
got this very dramatic
well, I wasn't
story.
Sure. I was gonna reveal. I'm doing a reveal.
We're doing a, reading a very dramatic story. This is kiddie time now, or adults, you know. It's Miffy's garden. So we're going to read Miffy's Garden with a very dramatic soundtrack written by Ludwig Maurer. Who, does anyone know any Maurer facts?
No.
Do you know any?
Born in 1789.
He's born in 1789. So he's Mozart. He's Mozart era. Mozart era. And originally, you did have some nerdy facts. This is originally written for.
It is. It's originally written for a brass band quintet of two cornets, two E-flat tenor horns, and a euphonium. But now we're going to do the modern transcription.
You did know, after all that.
I did know.
You give yourself some credit.
I was teasing.
Okay, so, Act 1. Miffy's Garden by Dick Brunner. I've changed the genders also, lads, so halfway through you see.
I'll stick on the page.
Okay. One day, Miffy's mammy says, "Goodness, how you've grown! I think you're big enough to have a garden of your own." To Miffy, a bag of carrot seed. She shows her how to sow it very carefully. When Miffy's bag is empty and all the seeds are set, she goes and fills her watering can and makes them nice and wet.
What's your dynamic there, Barney?
Perils of working with Brassic.
Perils of working with Philpott.
It was
so beautiful as well.
Oh, really? Right down the middle. Right down the middle, right in the slot.
Soon the plants began to grow. They begin to show, and though they're very small, Miffy knows that gradually they'll grow to be quite tall. When the plants are bigger, she pulls one up with care. As Miffy lifts it out, she finds a lovely carrot. A carrot! Miffy finds a carrot! Packed in Miffy's basket, her carrots look so neat all fresh and crisp and olive, and wonderful to eat. She takes her carrots out to show, and what does Daddy say? Your carrots look delicious. Let's have a feast today. Daddy cleans the carrots and lays them out with care, and stacked up on their bright blue plate, they're now ready to share. And when there's not one carrot left upon the empty plate, all three agree those carrots are the best they ever ate. The end.
Yay! The most serious basket.
Hello.
Boys, amazing. We have a birthday shout out already planned.
If you've got any birthdays that happened since last Thursday.
For little Ollie Hickey, who is 33 yesterday. Oh, wow. Ollie Hickey from Carl Shalton. So happy birthday, Ollie.
Do we have any more birthdays?
Let's know anyone else's birthday?
Anyone else had a birthday in the last week?
When's Dave's birthday?
Lisa.
Second show.
What? On Saturday, it's Dave's birthday!
Ah!
So we wanted to ask our online audience, would you like happy birthday in an Umpa style or in a New Orleans style? Them's your choices.
It's Deirdre's birthday
what?
Tomorrow.
Deirdre! Do I have that in my phone? Our number one fan. No, one of our number one
and
fans.
Our top three fans.
Top three fan. Deirdre's birthday is tomorrow.
And do you want to read it?
And how old will you be, Deirdre? Deirdre's birthday. Oh, rats.
She's put it in. She's put it in calendar.
Look, Deirdre's birthday.
Do any genre, really.
Yeah, any genre. They're very talented.
Let us know the style you'd like in it. There's about a 30-second delay, so you'll have to
add them.
Any more birthdays?
Well, Lisa, who we've already mentioned, she had her birthday on Saturday.
Happy birthday, Lisa.
Oh, it's New Orleans is the...
New Orleans, okay.
Yeah, it's coming through thick and fast.
I don't have a clarinet.
Deirdre's going to be 13.
Oh, yeah. Okay, I'm not going to take my turn out because there's other bits to go, so I'll leave you guys to it. New Orleans birthday for Dave, Ollie, Deirdre, Lisa.
How do you do that? New Orleans.
Clara wants New Orleans too.
Right, slow upbeat and off we go.
I'm going to social distance, sorry.
Deirdre says, all you boys, her garden next week, don't worry about your instruments.
Deirdre. Oh, Deirdre.
Whoa. See you there, Deirdre. I'm in.
Flies are done.
You got a pasta. Your flies are.
Deirdre's here already.
You've got a pot each there behind you.
Right, so let's get some rules. I don't. I'm Monica here. Flies up, get a pot each. That's where your potatoes. So your revealed potatoes go in your own pot.
Yeah.
Any muck that you need to get
can
out of the way.
Outside, so I can kneel down.
What am I doing? Just getting mud out.
Yeah. So get the mud out.
Can
the
I
mud
the
in
mud
this
on,
tub.
Not on. It's actually got some really bad parasites in it. In
so
the mud for the
mud in the mud tub.
Parasites.
No,
amazing.
It's not a parasite. It's
a bulb.
A bulb thing that grows up and it's really poisonous for cats.
Hey, this is fun.
Anyway,
basically, try and get the muck in there and not on the ground.
But then you're trying to get as many potatoes as you can. Collect them in your own bucket. You've got a minute.
Oh, you got 3 minutes.
Three whole minutes.
What in there?
Our tuba's ready. We'll wait till Jessie says go, but we'll let the tuba get us started.
On your mark.
Wait, let the tuba know though. The tuba starts, then you say.
Yeah,
go.
I'm on your mark. Oh, sorry. Go for it.
Thank you.
You wouldn't do that as a vegan, would you?
A bit of flora, a bit of mint, and some salt and pepper. Yeah. There's spud.
I see one. Oh, you got loads there.
Yeah, Seb, are you playing the game?
The mother load.
Tiny.
I can see two of them right there.
This is like my dream where you instead of jack a potato and baked beans, you have loads of little potatoes and one giant jacket bean.
He's got
a
face.
There's so many potatoes in here.
Mash!
What's your favourite kind of potato cooking, Jessie?
I'm a big mash fan.
Yeah,
mash.
Love
truffle
mash.
Oil.
Ooh.
Yeah.
Yes.
I've served that at a film and book club once.
Oh, yeah.
I have.
I think I remember that. Roast potatoes have got to be up there, haven't they?
Richard Evans made a story.
Da, na, 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 na.
Stop, stop, no more cheating, no more cheating.
I don't think there's any
more
cheating. Yeah. How many tubers do you get?
Nice work, Philpott.
Right, let's count them out. Count your tubers, guys.
I think, look, it's not about the size, it's about the quantity.
Okay.
Yeah, so how many you got? Count them each.
All right.
One.
Okay.
One.
Two.
I believe it's marked.
Remember that four.
Five. This is now not the greatest telly, just boys counting today.
Oh, you can tell us some facts about your next piece while they keep counting.
We're going to do, what are we going to do next?
Gershwin.
You can put your clarinet together.
Yeah, I got to put my clarinet together. Yeah, we're nearing the end of this show. So actually, these boys, this is all they're going to eat for a week, unless you guys donate to paypal.me/JessieGrimes.
20.
And we'll donate to
two.
Musicians.
What
was
it, Seb?
What
did you get?
22.
22.
Oh. Barney?
Barney.
20.
Oh,
we have a winner!
Mine are massive.
Come on! Well done, Sebby.
Thank you very much.
Barney, can you play the trombone with muck all over your face?
Sorry.
and a pandemic in your mouth.
You put a pandemic in me gob.
Who won?
Sebby won. You got
22. Oh, well done, Seb.
Thanks very much.
Very good.
20 big ones though, it doesn't count for anything.
Your mum says bless you, she remembers you doing this at play school.
We're going to finish up now, this is our last tune. We promised a play out. So we're going to do our final prelude, Gershwin prelude.
Oh no, I've ruined my jeans.
Oh dear. You've been cleaning the muck out of your trombone for weeks now.
Did you find the spatula?
Yeah, it is.
Right. Arranged by Sebastian Philpott.
some dinner after that.
Yeah, right. Everybody's instruments still functioning?
Just about. I think so.
Despite the blue sky, it's actually getting pretty cold in,
isn't it? Yeah.
So this is our final tune. Very talented Seb Philpott, very talented Barney Philpott, very talented Richard Evans, very talented James Pillai, very talented David Geoghegan, very talented Lauren Weavers on the split pea shaker.
Yeah.
Very talented Emma Murphy on the camera operation.
Yeah.
And general amazing wifeness. And I'm Jessie.
Jessie Ross!
Yeah.
Yeah.
Let's go.
Tuba.
Okay. Tuba. One, two, one, two.
Grimes, pay these lovely boys in more than potatoes and then donate to Help Musicians. We've raised 700 already. We're doing a tot up. We're going to add even more to the Help Musicians fund. So thank you so much, everyone, for joining. See you next week for the very last outdoor one, if we can bring electricity outside and it doesn't rain. Thank you to the gods of the garden jam for it not raining. And see you guys all next week.
Goodbye!
We're going to have a play out. We've not done a professional play out like this.
Yeah. One, two, three, four.